Welcome back. We have seen one example how to search in table view and how to filter objects based on the search and how to display the items which the user has selected. Now we see editing. How to edit? I have a couple of products. I just want to delete a couple of products from my table view and swipe. I'm having a couple of items here. I just want to remove when I swipe it. When I swipe it, I have to remove. Okay, this is the previous functionality what we are seeing here. I want to edit, actually editing the table view. How to edit it? What we can do is we are having a couple of methods. I'll write those methods in the table view. This is the table view delegate and data source. First of all, the table view asks to the view controller, can I edit? Can you edit table view? Yes, you can edit. Okay, there are editing styles like insert or delete. Franco, editing style for route index path. What is the editing style you want? What is, can commit on edit style? Commit, this is committing. Okay, commit we see. Editing style for route index path. What kind of edit you need? I want to show when user swipes, I want to show delete option. Okay, here comment editing style. When user swiped and delete, user swipe and clicked on delete, what we need to do? We need to remove objects from the products. Deleting means I need to delete the selected product. How to delete? Remove at index path, we have dot row and reload table view. Table view, we have. We can use table view or we are having product list view. Table view is the instance here. So we can use directly, or else you can also use the product list view. In interface, they will ask you how to refresh the table view. This is how you refresh. In interface, they will ask you how to refresh a particular row. I'll show you that as well. I'm swiping. When you hard swipe, it deletes. iPhone 6, I'm removing. Gone. iPhone, MacBook Pro 18, 13, I'm removing. Removed. Okay, what we are doing? These are the three different methods we have implemented for editing. Okay, it is asking, the table view is asking to the delegate or data source, is the view controller, is the delegate and data source asking view controller, can I edit the particular row? Yes, you can edit what we are telling. And what is the editing style? Whether you want to insert a new item or whether you want to delete, what needs to be displayed on swipe? Okay, delete, display, delete. And user clicked on delete, what should do? What should I do? Here you have to remove. If the editing style is insert, you can take user to another view control, another page, another view, another screen, where you can add new item, new entry. There, then you can check if it is delete. If editing style we have, right, editing style equal dot delete. If it is delete, do this. Otherwise, ignore. If it is insert, do something else. That is how you can write the logic. And what I want is when a user clicks on a particular cell, I want to change the color of that particular cell. I want to change the color of that. Okay, let's do that. Let's select route index path. When user clicks on that, I want to change the color of that. Okay, how to change the color means here when you call reload data, all the cells will be reloaded. But when user clicks on a particular cell, I just want to change the color of only that cell. How to do that? Okay, how to do that? What I can put is I can take one cell right here where selected cell index path. Index path equal to nil. In did select route index path, I am putting selected index path equal to index path. This cell user selected. I want to change the color of that. Okay, I can ask table view reload rows at index paths. I can pass a number of rows here. Here I can pass index path and row animation fade out, something will be there. You can take Okay. Let's see what happens. What I'm doing here, I am reloading. Instead of reloading entire table view, I'm just reloading this particular cell. Okay. And here cell for row at index path. Index path, small index path. Small index path. In cell for row at index path, what we need to do if selected cell index path equal to the current index path. If it is same, cell dot background color equal to EA color dot red. Otherwise, cell dot background color equal to dot white plain. What's on? There is something needs to be done, I guess. Equal to nil. Perfect. See? If that is the case, we don't need this, right? Actually, we don't need this selection. We don't need. So only, not here in select route index path, I don't have to reload the logic. Reload logic we have written for showing the check marks. Here I'm not showing check marks in this scenario. I just want to load the selected cell. Only the particular row, selected row, second row. What is the difference? What is happening here? You have reloaded this only cell. So only cell got reloaded. Change the color. You have reloaded only cell. So this cell also changed. This cell also changed. Okay, what we need to do here? What is the difference here is, sometimes you need to reload a particular row. This is the method what we need to do. Reload rows at index paths. Here I'm not reloading the particular cell. This only one. We are refreshing everything so that only selected index will be red color. Other things will be nothing, plain. Even the check mark also, you can do the same thing. You can put one index variable, and if it is instead of color, we can also put the check marks. If you want single selection. Here, if you see only single selection only, right? Even if you select multiple different cells, only one cell is getting selected. Similar way, you can put only check mark for the particular cell. Single selection. Now we have implemented multi-selection. Multi-selection. If you want a single selection, you can use this logic actually. Selected index equal to index path, track that variable. Clear? Hope this is clear. Let's this is how we edit. You can also edit, right? This is how we edit. Single selection also we have seen. Now I'll show you how to customize the table view. Let me take separate project for that. Customization is very, very important. Without customizing cell, table view cell, there is no product. There is no project actually. Custom table view. See, if you have not understand the table view properly, see it. Again, we are doing it freshly. Go to storyboard. UI table view. Set the constraints. Make 0, 0, 0, 0. Drag and drop table view cells. Okay. By default, the table view cell contains some properties like image view, title label, detail text label, detail text label, and accessory view. Now, what I want is I don't want to use them. I just want to use only label with multi-line text, or let's say I just want to use image view. But it should be at right side. And one more image view I want, it should be at left side. I want two text labels. I want two labels. One is top label, another one is bottom label. Okay, these are my text fields. I'll put some identifier. My identifier name is, I can take for now, custom cell. There are different ways, I am telling you. This is a cell, right? This is table cell only. What we are trying to do, we are trying to add some more properties. Left image view, right image view, top label, bottom label. To add some more properties to an existing class, what we need to do? We need to go for the inheritance, right? Let's go for inheritance. CocoaTouch class. Custom. It should be subclass of EA table view cell. Okay, custom table view cell is the one. EA table view cell is the super class. Perfect. We need to add those properties, right? Add those properties. What are those properties? I need two image views. Where left image view. Image view. Where a right image view. Image view. Where top title is label, where title is again UI label. Okay, perfect. Now what I want is already my custom table cell is created in storyboard. So instead of allocating memory for these programmatically, I can connect to them, right? IB outlet. For IB outlets, unit is the week. I'll tell you sometime why we are using week. Now you can connect them, right? Go and connect them. Now what we need to do, this is not the subclass of EA table view. Now this is a subclass of custom table view. Sorry, this is EA table view, the cell, which is not subclass of which is not class of EA table view cell. Now it is a custom table view cell. Now select the custom table view cell, don't select the view. Remember here, select the custom cell. It has some outlets. What are the item outlets? It has a bottom label. Take bottom label, left image view, this is the left image view, right image view, this is the right image view, top title, this is the top title. Perfect. Now let's set some constraints. Okay, I'm going to set constraints for this. From top 10 pixels, from right 20 pixels, from left I'm not left 20 pixels, right I'm not taking anything, and height some 10 pixels. Height is 88. Sorry, height is already calculated since we have set top and bottom. Width is 102. Perfect. Add four constraints. Similarly, you need to take trailing, top, bottom, set the fixed width. Width is fixed, top is 10, bottom I don't want, here right 20, bottom 10. Perfect. What's going on here? Remove, reset. Here 20 pixels, we need 20 pixels. Here 10 pixels, maybe we need to use minus width. Though it is showing, maybe are we using some margins? Check this, clear everything. Go here, remove margins, 20 pixels, 10 pixels. Here I don't want anything. 20 pixel, right, top 10 pixels, bottom 10 pixels. Okay, remove this. You can also enable, disable. Perfect. Width we have not set, right? Set the width as well. Width. Okay. And label should be always in the center. Top some space and always in the, be in the center. Horizontally center. Similarly this, also same from the bottom 10 pixels and always be in the center, horizontally center. Perfect, everything is clear, there are no red marks. Now what we need to do, we need to tell table view you are controlled by vController, table view you are controlled by vController. Go to vController, implement the methods by using extension vController. Your table view data source is enough, data source itself is enough for us. Generally we take table view delegate as well. What are the two methods we need? We need two methods which are by default you will get. Fix it. How many number of rows you want? We are having four objects, right? Let's take four objects in the cell where products. I will take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five objects. Number of rows I want is 5. Products dot count. And here cell for row index path. I can ask later cell equal to. For custom cell, it is different. See how it is different. DQ table view DQ reusable cell with identifier. Try this first. DQ reusable cell with identifier. What is the identifier? Custom cell. Go and check in the storyboard. Do you have the same thing? Select the cell. Reuse for the cell. We have not set any identifier. Set it. Custom cell. Perfect. It is custom cell. We can also tell that if later it is custom cell, it is assuming it is table view cell. We can take custom table view cell. If it is custom table view cell, cell dot top label. If you do not set this, it doesn't show you the top label, bottom label, and all. It treats it as your table view cell. The return type of DQ reusable cell is your table view cell, not the custom table view cell. So that we are telling, no, no, it is not your table view cell. It is custom table view cell. It has so and so properties. Top label. I'm just putting top cell dot bottom label dot text. I'm just putting bottom instead of using the product. You can also try to do this. And we do not have images, right? Let's go and set the images. Assets library, images. Take some image. 3997 is the image. Cell dot left image. Left image we has a property called image. Your image. Image named. Give the name 3997. 3997. Same thing I can do for right image view. Okay. Finally, return it. Return the cell. Here, if the it is not hitting anything. If custom table cell is not found, what we need to do? We need to return your table cell. Empty cell. I am returning. Run it. See if it is working. If it is not working, there is something wrong. Maybe we need to register it. Let's see. Only top is displayed. See, why this? Okay, what we can do is actually the image size is bigger. So it is showing something like this. We can set a proper width and a proper height. What is the method? Cell height for row index path. Height for row index path. What is the height I want is 150. Basically, we are having four different objects here. You can take four different arrays based upon your requirement. I don't want to use the anything, I just want to use the hard code values. Okay, this is how you can use the custom table view cell. customized. Okay. And the second way I'll show you. This is one way. Okay. Let's save this. We also show how to use the flexible table view. Like if the content is more, it should automatically expand. Custom table view. Perfect. Now, what I want is another way of using the custom table view cell. I'm just removing this class, move to trash, or use remove reference. Generally, if you want to completely delete, you use the move to trash. Okay. Actually, there are some outlets. If you see, just remove them. This is table cell, and there is no custom cell, right? There is no custom cell class. So remove this. There is no custom cell class. This is table cell only now. Okay. Even the connections also remove. There is no class. See, the warnings also it is giving. It is plain, simply drag and drop. Now what I can do is for this I can set the tag 101. For this I can set 102. For this I can set 001. Tag, where is tag? This is one. For this I'll set two. Basically giving some IDs. Here there is no custom cell, right? There is no custom cell. The name, the reuse identifier is there. Reuse identifier is custom cell only. You can put custom cell. Now these properties will not be working now because top title is not there. These are not there. So what we need to do? First of all, we need to access the image views labels, then set the value. I am trying to access the image views first. If you let left image view equal to cell, on top of cell we are having, right? We are having view with tag, that is 101. 101 is left image view. If let right image view cell dot view with tag, this is one method which is again important. View with tag, this is right image view. If left image view is available with the so and so tag, set the image. How to set the image? This is how we set the image. What is that? Left image view dot image. It is treating as view. If you see view with tag, it is view. Actually, we know that we have given 101 for the image view, so that we can ask that, right? Yes, your image view. Similarly here, yes, your image view. Treat it as your image view. Now left image view equal to so and so, right image equal to so and so. Right image view is this, left image view is this. I'll just jot C left image view. Okay. Now I'll remove everything and show you clearly B. For the labels also we can do the same thing. Running, there are no errors. Same thing we are getting. For labels we have not set any title. Okay, custom table view cell can be created in two different ways. One is by taking subclass of UI table view cell. Another one is by taking tags. Here you don't need any kind of subclassing. In the table view cell itself, you can drag and drop some items and you can set the tag for them. And the way of accessing is you're asking cell, is there any view with so and so tag 101? If it is there, return it. I'm setting, if it is image, set some image. Here also same thing. For the label also I can do is do it, right? Top label, the ID what we have set is 1. I know it is label, so I'm asking, try to treat it as label. If it is label, set some text, top label Else I just want to print index path. How to print the index path? String interpolation I can use, right? Index path dot row. String interpolation. In interviews, they will ask what are the different ways so the custom cell can be created. These are the two different ways. Okay, now I am displaying the index paths. This is how we use. We also see how to use the flexible table view cells. Here we are setting hard coded value 150 is the hard code value. Now, in some applications, if you see the text view is more, the cell height also will be more. We see that how to use the custom cell with such content. Flexible content, how to use the normal cell with such content, and what else is left in table view. Most of the stuff is already covered. If you guys need anything more on table view, please comment on description in the video comment session. Please like, do subscribe. Thank you for watching.